Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you the quickest, most effective way to create wood carvings from photos. For your convenience, I provided this photo of a wood texture. Feel free to use any wood texture you like. Open a photo of someone or something that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. We'll place it onto the wood background by making sure our Move tool is active and dragging our subject onto the tab of the wood base. Without releasing our mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize and position it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it in or out. Then drag it into position. To accept it, click the check mark at the top or press Enter or Return. I'll click the Cancel icon since I already sized and positioned it earlier. Next, we'll separate our subject from the background. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, open your Quick Selection tool and at the top, click the Select Subject button. It automatically selects our subject. To check it, press Q to see it as a quick mask. If you notice areas that weren't selected, or areas that you don't want selected, press Q again to revert it back into a selection and drag your Quick Selection tool over the areas you want selected. To remove unwanted areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. We'll place a white background under it by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill it with white, but before we do, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard or click this icon. If they're inverted, press X or click this icon. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill our empty layer with white. Make the subject layer active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and replace our subject with another without having to redo the effects. To do this, shift-click the white layer to make it and the subject active as well, and click the icon at the upper right. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Stylize, and Emboss. Make the angle minus 135 degrees. I'll make the height 5 pixels and the amount 500% based on the size and resolution of this image. However, if you're using a different image, you may want to adjust its height and amount based on your image's size and resolution. Change its blend mode to soft light. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Double-click Emboss of the copy to open it. Change the height to 8 pixels and the amount to 200%. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. I'll blur it 6 pixels.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.